and he is here to talk about the derivatives market, how to trade in basically futures and options. So he also worked on implementing, building and implementing basically algorithm based systems. So if you have any queries, you can raise it and he can also help you out with that. Thank you so much. And you know, I call upon Mr. Sundar to take over.
Good afternoon to everyone. Firstly, you know, it helps the speaker if he knows where his audience stands to start with. So if we can spend the first 5 minutes introducing yourself and basically about, can you hear me without the mic?
Yeah. That's much better.
And what exactly you're looking from the program also in terms of derivatives, where we stand. So if you could just have a brief, it helps me take it further better. Starting. Active trader, or you know, you're doing it for your own trading purpose or training purpose or you know, academic interest. If you could just have some brief about that.
I'm an active trader. Basically, basics mean I'm expecting something more, especially in the options, how to improve myself and how to use the internet.
Okay.
I think basics we all know.
Okay.
That's what my opinion.
I trade in Nifty,
okay,
and follow the daily chart.
Okay.
So what I was looking here for, like, because what happens sometimes trading up and down, but whenever you put the product, it goes against you.
Okay.
Always. Most of the time. So put some focus on that.
Yeah. Okay. Fair.
Demand is more.
Okay.
They are supposed to close the position, so it will rise up.
Yeah. So when the cost of carry is going up, that means the speculators are entering more. But when the underlying is going up, that means the investors are entering more. Right? So this means, this actually means speculative positions are going higher. Slightly higher, but underlying is also going higher. Yeah. So there is a bit more of speculative, and what do you do under the circumstance? Generally, as per this is a bit of a market inside information, so please take it with a pinch of salt. So generally what happens is, people who are informed, you know, they get some amount of news or something about that an institution might buy or somebody might buy. Okay? Might be buying later today. That is when the speculators get in first. When the speculators get in, the cost of carry starts increasing. And when it starts increasing with the open interest, that means right now the speculator is in, probably the buyer is going to come soon. There is already a little bit of buying there in the underlying. Probably, it is a buy signal. So, but you know that it is more the speculator who is buying at this point. Buy signal, probably you have to put some strict, everything requires strict stop losses or whatever trading strategies, but that is how you analyze in the first place, and this is how you work this. Yeah, any questions? So what should be the next one?
Falling cost
of carry, rising open interest, increasing delivery volumes, increasing underlying price.
Back to the previous one.
Yeah.
Carry is increasing. I think you are boosting the open interest.
Yeah.
And so increasing volume. But if the first two are same, the cost of carry is increasing, the open interest is increasing. But the delivery volumes are decreasing.
We'll come to each scenario differently. We'll come all
the next chapters, right?
Yeah. We'll come to each scenario. Every scenario will happen. So the next scenario is falling cost of capital.
What does this mean?
Rising underlying prices, falling cost of carry, increasing delivery volumes, rising open interest.
Speculators are coming out.
Speculators are exiting. If they're exiting, then why is the event or some? Something is seen by somebody in the market. That is why it is formed a rock. When it fails, it means probably that event is not taking shape. Today you started your company and you know you've got a 100 crore order. So you know at the end of the year this will be a balance sheet. So based on that, there is a saucer that is formed on your company's graph or chart, on the chart of your company. Now, if for some reason the order has not been executed right, maybe you won't get that revenue, then it fails. So, a failure of some kind of expectation is what leads to shortcoming. Now, it might be that it's a temporary failure, it might be that the interest rates will still go up a little later. If it's not gone up today, okay, next meeting it will definitely go up, or if it's not, it will definitely fall. So, there could be people who are not, who are willing to buy more time and roll their position over. It's not necessary that everybody has to come up. So that will determine. So there's no way of predicting the magnitude, without having the actual insight of
it. The negative news is going to cause this shortcoming.
There is positive news that's going to cause the shortcoming. If there is negative news, the stock is going to fall.
When this positive news is going to...
It could be a positive news, or it could be the failure of a negative news. People might be expecting that there will not be any interest rate cut today, but the RBI might come and surprisingly announce that there is a cut. That will trigger off the rise in covering into shorts, the banks, and then the prices start moving.
The question is whether this will sustain or whether it will revert back.
It will not sustain. sir. Once the target is fulfilled, then market will become
market. Yeah, after the covering is over, market will chart. What course the market will chart will depend on further factors. That is not predetermined. That, for now, we only have so much. Only till that point begins. Okay. So, the factors that option pricing are affected by? Time decay? Yes, sir.
Volatility.
Okay. So, what is volatility? What are the kinds of volatility that are there? Implied volatility?
Historical
volatility? Okay, annual volatility is the same. See, what is historical volatility? What is implied volatility? And finally, there will be a realized volatility, which you don't need at this stage. What is the historical volatility in a stock? What is the historical volatility in an index? Let's say it's 19-20%, whatever it is, using the Black-Scholes. Nifty has something which goes on. Sometimes it's 16, sometimes it's 18, even goes to 64, it did in 2008. It was the extreme it went to. So that is a variant. So when will the volatility increase and when will the volatility decrease? That's the next question.
When should goes down very quick? That's when it increases.
When the market goes down very quick, the market that's when it increases. Okay.
Rapid changes.
Usually the most rapid change.
Rapid changes means increases.
Okay. So generally it is seen that the rising markets don't show too much of volatility increase. It's the falling markets that show. If the prices are stagnant at any point of time, then what is it then?
No volatility.
And if volatility are increasing, that means the price of the option increases, right? So if the price of the option is increasing for the same price at which the futures are, what does that mean?
That means they're expecting more volatility in the stock.
They're expecting more volatility in the stock. That means basically the writer of the option wants a premium, which is higher. If the writer of the option wants a premium that is higher, that means there is probably more volatility than you are expecting in the market. So if the open interest is increasing and the volatility is increasing, the implied volatility, implied is the one which is used to price the option. If these two are increasing, that means you really cannot make out with the options whether the markets are going to move up or move in. That means you really cannot say somebody is writing options there in a big way. Right? Options market come in different ways. Not here. See, there are two things when, if you have to, either you can buy an option or you write an option. So we'll consider the writer for this moment. We're keeping the buyer out of it. When will you write options? You will write call options when you think the market is going to go down. You will write put options when you think market will go up. You will write, if the volatility in the markets increases, that means the price that you are going to write an option is going to be higher than what you wrote yesterday, if today the volatility is higher. That means, if the price of the option is going up, the other way around, the volatility of the option has increased. When the volatility in the option has increased and the open interest is also increased, it generally happens during any event. It could be, election times and all, it's huge. The pricing of options are huge. It could be some event, RBI or Fed, FOMC. Could be any of the events which can
happen.
Yeah. So, this kind of increase, that means the writer of the option is expecting more volatility in the options. And more volatility in the market. So, at that time, does it make sense to infer anything here? Not really. So, let us take the other way around. If the writer of the option comes and sells it at a lower volatility than whatever is existing, then what is that? No, the first scenario,
you have the writer of the option who is selling options and who is demanding a higher price. Today the option price is 100 rupees. Tomorrow he is demanding the same price Nifty is, or you know, the same equivalent, it can't be the same. So the same equivalent is demanding a price of 105 for that, or 103 for that. Right? Let's say it will come to 0.4. So if it is a 9200, it will come to probably 0.3. Right? So when you have this increasing and decreasing, so that means when you have this increasing and decreasing, you have a certain amount of delta value that is different for different strike options. That's what it is. The rate at which the delta will change is known as gamma. Okay, we leave gamma aside for a while. Theta is the time value, vega is a reflection of change in implied volatility, and rho is the change of interest rate. For delta hedging, what happens is, let's say today you have 9000 is what we spoke about as the Nifty futures end, and you have a delta of 0.5. So if I sell 10 lots of 9000 option and buy 5 lots of futures, what am I essentially doing? I'm at delta 0.
Yeah,
I'm delta 0. So if the market goes up by 100 points, the delta will become 0.6 from 0.5. So I'll buy one more lot. Right? If the market comes down, I will. I sold 10 lots of options, call options, and I bought 5 lots of futures. If the market goes up by 100 points, right now the delta of the option is 0.5. So the option prices will go up, 10 lots of options will give me the same money as 5 lots of futures. So the market goes up by 100 points. So net net I am neutral. It's going to have a zero effect on my portfolio. So when it has gone up by 100 points, the delta of the 9000 call will become 0.6. Because now, at some point it behaves like a future, right? The option. So now when it becomes 0.6, I buy the 6th lot. So if I keep managing the delta like this throughout the month, then I will actually end up eating all the time value that is there. There is an implied volatility, there is a realized volatility. There is a historical volatility. The implied volatility is never going to be equal to this. Historical volatility is always going to be at a premium. So finally there will be a realized volatility which is likely to be equal to the historical volatility. So in between this volatility there will be a certain amount of, in simple words, there will be a certain amount of time value which the option carries which I can end up using. That is what this delta hedge. That is basically what lot of prop tests do. Lot of proprietary tests do this. They hedge the delta and but it requires very active management and it requires, you know, too much hands-on, and initially you will have a lot of market movements where you have a lot of gap ups and gap downs, which is like, it should take away, it will make things difficult for you, so. But this is one thing which has, there are a lot of people in the market who do this. That is why the option open interest, when you go back, you know, there are a lot of the option in the open interest is created by even these delta hedges. That is why if it is low implieds, if the implieds are not going low, implieds are normal and the open interest is higher, that means there is no meaning to option open interests. That's why I said you have to specifically look at implieds going lower and options. But this is another set of players who come into the market.
But it goes down from 9,000 to 8,900.
If it goes, then you will make it 0.4. You will square off one lot of future. You keep managing the delta. You will keep managing the delta. Any questions? These are things, something which is more interesting. How many of you here are from an IT background? IT. So this might interest them more than anyone else.
pricing inconsistency of markets. What is actually HFT? A lot of people have talked about HFT, high frequency trading, algorithm based trading. What are these things? What exactly is it? Let me hear it from you.
Machine will trade on its own.
Machine will trade on its own. So how does it trade on its own? Yeah. So what are the kind of logic you can build into a machine? Mismatching of price. What is mismatching of price?
In terms of time wise or different market or say
4 or 5 days, we can provide you live data as and when we are analyzing, and we can provide you how we are reading it and what are the calls basically on the derivative side. Right? So we can form a sort of informal, if you allow, discussion forum wherein everybody can pitch in. And we can share whatever our research desk puts out so that you can understand from live data what are the prices that are happening and what is it that can make a profitable trade setup only on the options. Is that possible?
It's possible. We can do it off the system.
Yeah. Sure. Outside.
So do we have any more questions?
The first part, we have not made any notes. So we don't need any notes, or can we take some photos of?
No, probably we will share this presentation.
Is it a PDF one?
Yes. In the PDF. To your email, please.
Sir, one last thing I wanted to ask. This was something basic, and I just put it that 90% was just nothing but textbook admissions. However you might look at it. What my next question is, what is the next higher event that you be conducting, where if we can come, attend, and next day go and sit at the table and start trading in the manner in which you have corrected us, not merely taught us, but corrected us. Is there any event which is
there? That's what you said, no?
Like
the number, they will take
that. That is,
yes.
That is something which is...
coming all the way here and giving us a wonderful presentation about derivatives. And also we would like to give a presentation, a small memento as a token of appreciation from us.